Ready? It's sing-along time.
Look down from the sky and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh.
Hi friends, my name is Duann and I'm so excited that you can join me this month. We're going to be talking about the King of Kings. And do you know who the King of Kings is? Shout it out on the count of three. One, two, three. Yes, it's Jesus. And that's our big idea this month. Jesus is the King of Kings. Come and join me as we look at this globe. This is a globe. And look at all the countries on the globe. Now, all these countries throughout all of time have had their own kings. That's so many kings. But do you know who is the greatest king of all kings, and he is the king forever? It's Jesus. So, before Jesus was born, God picked kings to lead his special family, the Israelites. Let's go hear about one of them.
Storytime!
Hi friends, I'm Willem. Today I'm gonna be reading a story about Solomon. Let's get into it. Remember David?
Hello.
He was a shepherd and a musician. And when he was young, God chose him to be the king of his people, the Israelites. Remember him? He had a son named Solomon. When David died, Solomon became king of God's people, the Israelites. The people really liked Solomon. He was a good king. One night, when Solomon was asleep, he had a dream. In the dream, God told Solomon that he would give Solomon anything he wanted. Anything. Can you imagine? What would you ask for? Oh, that would be really good. But Solomon didn't ask for anything like that. Solomon asked God for wisdom. Wisdom is knowing what to say and do even when it's really hard. And guess what? God gave him wisdom. And he gave him all sorts of other stuff too, just because he didn't ask for really selfish things. Because God had given Solomon such amazing wisdom, people came from all across the kingdom to get Solomon's help and wisdom. And God helped Solomon to be a good king. And Solomon loved God. Solomon knew that God was the King of Kings. Solomon was so thankful to God for all he had done for him, and Solomon wanted to show his thanks to God in some way. And so, Solomon built a special place for God, a temple. Today we would call that like a church. He built it to show how much he loved God. Wow, what a great story. Can you imagine God asking you for anything you could ever want, and you picking wisdom, and God rewarding you for that? That's pretty cool. All right, now it's on over to activity time.
Activity time!
That was such a great story. Solomon was such a wise king. Well, we know that Jesus is the greatest king of all. Okay, I have a very fun game for us, and I invited some friends to join us. I invited Natasha and Evan. Remember that, Natasha and Evan. Can you help me call them? On the count of three. One, two, three. Natasha! Evan!
Hi, friends.
Hi, Duann.
Hi, friends. Hi, Duann.
Hi, guys. It's so great to see you.
I'm so excited to be here.
We are going to play a game called Wise or Not Wise. Do you want to know how it goes?
Yes, how does this go, Duann?
Okay, I have a card here, and there are some statements. I'm gonna read them. If what I say is wise, you're gonna jump forward, and we're gonna shout yay! If what I say is not wise, you're gonna jump backwards, I'm gonna hit the buzzer, because it's not wise. Got it?
Okay, so let me check. If it's wise, we jump forward like this.
And if it's not wise, then we jump backwards like this.
You got it. Did you guys get it? Are you ready?
I am so ready.
Let's get this started.
Okay, first statement. I didn't listen to my mom. Wise or not wise?
I think you should always listen to your parents.
Yeah, I don't think that's really wise. Friends, what do you think?
Yeah, that's not really wise, is it?
No.
Okay, well, let's take one hop back.
You're right.
Yes.
That's not very wise.
We got it, friends.
Okay, next statement. I helped my friend up when they fell down. Wise or not wise?
Well, that was really sweet, helping their friend up, right?
Yeah, I think that's wise, because we should always help one another.
Absolutely. Friends, do you agree? Yeah. Let's take one hop forward.
Yay! Yes, that was wise. And that was kind, too.
Yes, it was.
Next one. I asked God to help me. Wise or not wise?
I don't even have to think about this
one. Yeah, that one's super wise. You should always ask God for help.
Absolutely. Friends, what do you think? Yeah? I think that was wise. Let's hop forward.
Yes! It was wise!
Yes!
Friends, we got it again!
Okay! This is awesome. Let's do one more. I shared my toys with my friend. Wise or not wise?
That's wise.
That's pretty wise.
You should always share with people.
Exactly. Have you heard the statement, sharing is caring? Exactly. Friends, what do we think? Wise?
Let's take a jump forward.
Yes, that was wise. Okay, another one. I didn't take time to listen to God. Wise or not wise?
That's not wise. You should always take time to listen to God.
Absolutely. Friends, do you agree? Let's take a hop back.
That's right, that was not wise.
Got it again.
Okay, this one may be a little tricky, friends. Okay, listen carefully. I spent all of my birthday money on candy. Wise or not wise?
That's wise. Candy's amazing.
I love candy too, but you know, I've been reading this book that I really wanted to buy, and I feel like I could have saved a little bit of that birthday money for my book.
Oh yeah, then a book would last longer and you could use it more.
Exactly, and you can share it with your friends. Sharing is caring. All right, friends, what do we think?
I think we'd take a jump forward.
I think we'd take a jump back.
Or
it's
back.
Not wise. All right, friends, let's take a jump back. Yeah! That was really hard.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's probably not wise to spend all your money on candy. All right, this is the last one, guys. Are you ready?
Yep.
Yes!
This one's probably gonna be really hard.
Okay. I thank God, the Father, for Jesus coming to earth. Wise or not wise?
That one wasn't even a challenge.
Exactly.
That's really wise.
That's always wise. Let's take a hop forward, a big one.
Yes, that was wise. Great job, guys.
Thank you so much for helping us with that. We needed all the help possible. I hope you all had fun.
After all that jumping, we can finally sit down because it's key verse time.
Yay!
Key verse.
Are you ready to learn the key verse? The key verse this month is, Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. Okay, I'm so excited to do the key verse with you today because we're gonna learn American Sign Language together. All right, do you remember the sign for Jesus? Put your hands up. Point your middle fingers. Okay, you're gonna touch your palm with your middle fingers. Remember? Jesus. Jesus. Great. Okay, Jesus is. He is. Point your finger in the air. Touch your other finger with your thumb. The other one you do a thumbs up. He is. Hit it twice. Jesus is. Great. Okay, let's try both of those together. Jesus is. Great. Okay, what was the rest of the verse? King. Jesus is king, right? How do we do the sign for king? Put up your bunny ears. But look, on the other side, I put my thumb on my finger, so it kind of looks like a K. K for king. Okay, now we're gonna bring that to our shoulder and down to our hip. King. King. Got it? Okay, but Jesus isn't just the only king, he's the greatest king above all. How would we show that? Two thumbs up. Above all. Above all. Okay, let's put that together. So, king, the greatest king of all. You got it? You wanna try it again? The greatest king of all. Okay, let's put it all together. You ready? We'll go really slow. Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. Did you get it? Let's try it again. Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. Okay, let's try it one more time, okay? You ready? Jesus is the greatest king of all. Revelation 17, verse 14. That was great, friends. Let's see if you can teach that to someone today.
Prayer time.
almost time to say goodbye. But before we do,
may I pray with you?
How about today we stretch our arms big and wide, like we're gonna give God a hug? Are you ready? Let's pray. Dear God, thank you that you care for us always. And thank you for sending your son Jesus to earth. And thank you that he's our king and that he's the greatest king of all. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I had so much fun with you today, and I look forward to seeing you again next time. Bye-bye.